Well, they all start with Bell, don't they? It's a chilly -9 this morning. And if you don't believe me, that's where I am. And that's the temperature. As you can see, I've got the thermal blinds up on the window. They're a new addition this year. I had the cover, or the back of them, covered with black waterproof fabric, so it still looks stealth from outside. And I suppose you're wondering whether or not the chandelier actually worked last night. Well, to be fair, I didn't actually put it on. I was quite toasty without it. As you can hear, the air dispatcher's going, so that's keeping it very nice and toasty. And the hot water bottle worked an absolute treat. But, yeah, -9 this morning. Once I've had my breakfast, I'm going to have a wander around in the cold and see what Turku has to offer. And then it'll be the ferry tomorrow.
Is it just me, or is it hard to agree with what you're trying to explain?
I don't really know anything much about this particular building. The only things I do know is that it's one of the oldest buildings still in use in Finland today. And it dates back from the late 12th to the early 13th century. I'm going to see if I can find out a little bit more.
We'll see. We can go for walks, stroll down the city park, and maybe, just maybe, sweet delivery is never guaranteed, no matter the place or time.
Yeah, entrance to the castle, €12, which I think is a little bit steep. So I'm going to be a bit of a Scrooge and not pay the money. I've had a little walk around the grounds in any case. Let's see what else there is to do in Turku.
We can go for walks, stroll down the city park, and maybe, just maybe, take my hand, come on, let's go.
Different look and feel to this place. It's very calm and sedate, very measured, peaceful. Absolutely love it. Given a choice between this and Helsinki, Turku every time. Who knew? Thank you. no more swimming for me today. That was St. Henry's Ecumenical Arch Chapel. Really interesting piece of architecture, and I thoroughly recommend it. Although, getting here was a bit of a journey. You think I'd ever think about churches, but I don't. In the main, when you're travelling, they are something to do. They're warm and they're dry. And most importantly, when you're on a road, they're free. Or they ask for a small donation. But as I said, no more filming for me. I'm going to consolidate and wait out the ferry, which is tomorrow morning, early doors. And that's the 11-hour ferry to Stockholm. So unless something takes my eye, I'm going to remain incommunicado until such time as I reach Stockholm. And then I'll take up filming when I'm back on the road on the other side. Just as a bit of a footnote, really, for the last couple of days, I've been scurrying around the various parts of Finland trying to find places to park. And there are plenty of places to park. They're abundant, they're everywhere. But I just didn't understand what the situation was. And I kept seeing signs like this popping up every now and again. And I didn't have a clue what it meant until today, really. The last day that I'm supposed to be here. Basically, you can park as long as you see the signs and use one of these. You have a parking badge and you can buy them from any of the shops or the petrol stations. The idea being that you put the time that you arrive at the parking space, and if that parking space is going for 2 hours, 2.5 hours or 8 hours, you put that time that you arrive, and then obviously 8 hours later the ticket man can come round and give you a ticket. So if you are in Finland, or if you're looking at going to Finland and you're driving, make sure you get one of those, and parking then becomes free for that allotted time. Trust me to find out on the last day.